Hello everyone. Welcome to the course Dynamic Neural Network Programming with PyTorch. My name is Anastasia. I'm a data scientist with around 5 years of experience, and now I'm working at Samsung AI Center here in Moscow. Meanwhile, I participate in machine learning educational programs. I teach students from MIPT machine learning, computer vision, and text data mining. Moreover, I'm working on online courses, including Coursera NLP specialization. To my mind, it is of key importance to share professional experience with other people to help them develop their professional skills. This course is aimed at developers who want to extend their skill set to neural networks using PyTorch. This course would also appeal to someone who has basic understanding of ML concepts and Python programming, but now wants to learn how to implement it with PyTorch. So, let's go a little further into detail. First, we will start with PyTorch recap and call to mind PyTorch basics. Then, we are going to learn how to debug PyTorch code without any difficulties by running parts of the code and inspect it in real time. The next part is diving into dynamic neural network programming and learning how to create C++ or NumPy extensions. After it, we are going to get hands-on experience and focus on real-life applications instead of theoretical knowledge or toy examples. The first problem we are going to work with is image captioning. Here, we will get to know about encoder-decoder architectures and cover convolutional neural networks and recurrent neural networks. Then, we will build a pipeline for solving image captioning tasks on a real huge dataset. The last but not the least section is devoted to natural language processing, and here we will talk about several NLP tasks and we'll cover word embeddings, sentiment analysis, and even text generation. Okay, what else? For successful completion of this course, you will require the computer systems with at least the requirements from this slide. You will definitely need a processor with CUDA-enabled GPU. For an optimal experience with hands-on labs and other practical activities, I recommend configuration presented in this slide. Comparing with the previous slide, more random access memory and storage is required. As far as software is concerned, you will definitely need to install Python, PyTorch, and CUDA Toolkit. If you don't have all the stuff already installed, don't worry. We will cover all the installation issues in the next video. So, let's get started.